My dear brothers and sisters, the Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory be to O Lord. The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in Isaiah the prophet, Behold, I send my messenger before thy face, who shall prepare thy way? The voice of one crying in the wilderness, Prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. John the baptizer appeared in the wilderness, preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And there went out to him all the country of Judea and all the people of Jerusalem, and they were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair and had a leather girdle around his waist, and ate locusts and wild honey, and he preached, saying, After me comes he who is mightier than I, the thong of whose sandals I am not worthy to stoop down and untie. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. The Gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, we are in the second Sunday of Advent. And the second Sunday of Advent speaks about authenticity and also in a way austerity and humility. Now authenticity and what is called austerity and humility, these three aspects of both the persons that we have just read, John the Baptizer and Jesus Christ himself. Now, my dear brothers and sisters, I would like to tell you about Mahatma Gandhi. Now, Mahatma Gandhi was a barrister from a well-known university. And my dear brother and sister, being a barrister was a very high, dignified person. But when he came on the stage, he came with a dhoti and without shirt, but right his naked body. And some people like British call him fakir. But my dear brothers and sisters, he was such an authentic leader that everybody appreciated him. And then he had come to give his view about the liberation of India. And he said, I want to tell you today that we will have non-cooperation movement and a non-violent movement. This is what he may have learned from Jesus Christ when he read his gospel. But because he was so authentic, in a way so austere in his life, and he was also in a way so humble, that he said, it is not I, but all of us together will work for this liberation movement. And my dear brothers and sisters, suddenly a man shouted from the crowd, "Zindabad, Zindabad, Mahatma Gandhi Zindabad." And everybody responded. And that was the beginning of his success. My dear brothers and sisters, today, as we have two characters, especially when we see John the Baptist. Now, John the Baptist seems to have gone out in the wilderness to preach. And when he preached, he had a very simple clothes. As we are told, he was wearing camel skin and only a girdle around his waist. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, I want to tell you today that because of one's austerity, people think they have given up everything in order to serve us. So John the Baptist had given up everything in order to serve and serve God and serve his humanity. And so therefore what he ate was just little honey or maybe some little fruits from the wilderness. So my dear brothers and sisters, first and foremost, we are called to be austere. Don't think we are very big people and I cannot forgive this person, I cannot forgive that person, I am so dignified. No. You see the life of John the Baptist. When he was asked, "Whether are you the one who is supposed to come as Messiah?" And he said, "No." "Are you the one prophet?" "No." "Are you Elijah?" "No." So he said, "I am not even worthy to untie the shoes of the one who is coming in you." So humble and so simple. And that shows how precious his life was. And therefore people listened to him very keenly. And they wanted to know who is this person. And why he is preaching. And what is he preaching? He is only preaching simple thing. Just repentance and forgiveness of your sins. And so my dear brothers and sisters, this is what we admire in the life of John the Baptist. And this is what he probably able to say to people, that he is trying to not pick up attention to himself, but focusing his life on Jesus. He is the Messiah, he is the liberator, he is God. "I am no one. I am only a voice in the wilderness." And so my dear brothers and sisters, in life we are also called to be humble. And only when we are humble and we are austere, then our voices can show how authentic we are. And so though he was really behaving as a very poor person, he authentically preached because he had come from God in order to proclaim and prepare the way of Jesus. That is what his authenticity counted. And so my dear brothers and sisters, when we talk about Jesus himself, now Jesus himself was highly authentic because he himself was God. He lived a very austere life because he probably had no house now. When he came, probably he just put one small dress for himself as in public and preached to God. He didn't bother about his eating and drinking and wearing and what shoes and all that. No, very simple life, very austere life. renunciation, renounce. That is what he had to preach, therefore he had to behave accordingly. So first, we also say sometimes, bole taisa chale tachi vandavi pavne. People will really follow you if you are practicing what you preach. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, today we have to learn from these two characters that how authentic, how austere or renouncing, and how humble we are before God. Only when we are humble, then we can repent and prepare for our way for Christ. People who are very proud and not ready to repent, they can never confess themselves. And so there are people among us who have never come for confession, is mainly because they feel we don't need that. Means my mind, heart and mind not ready to repent before God. As some people who confess very often, they will say, Father, every day I am committing sins. How can I not confess? So there are two types of people here. And especially during this season before Christmas, because Christmas is the gift of God, when Jesus is coming in us to liberate us free from all sins and devils, so that we can be totally free. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, as we are preparing ourselves for this particular event of the second Sunday of Advent, let us focus ourselves on John the Baptist and focus ourselves on Jesus, their lifestyles and their message, because their message is the saving message for the whole world. My dear brothers and sisters, what is important is people responded to John the Baptist. They went to the desert where he was preaching. And we are told people came from Judea, people came from Galilee, and people came from everywhere. That means all of them thought that this person is so authentic. We need to listen to his voice and his message so that we can prepare ourselves for the coming of the Messiah, so that we can be really liberated and free people in the name of God. So today, as we prepare, let us sit for a moment and reflect. Close your eyes and see, how can I accept this message of John the Baptist? Now we are told, especially in the first reading, also Isaiah the prophet, he is telling people that we must also be able to really prepare ourselves so much for the forgiveness of God. God is so kind, God is so compassionate, God is forgiving. He is inviting us for his new covenant. And so that is how Isaiah is trying to prepare these people for the first coming, especially when it was the time when Israel was under Babylonian. And at the time of Isaiah, when Babylon had given freedom to these people to go back to Judea, so the Jews can be in their own place. And that is how God's mercy was realizing. So my dear brothers and sisters, the mercy of God is always with us. And also St. Paul in the second reading telling us today that we should be hopeful. And we are certainly hopeful if we really practice these virtues that are proclaimed by these great people who are our prophets and who Jesus, who is our Messiah.